About 20 million tons of natural rubber are used per year. So many different industries use natural rubber. Tire production for cars, buses, trucks, and planes used about 70% of the world's natural rubber supply in 2016. Rubber is also essential in healthcare, manufacturing, and construction, to name a few other industries. Rubber is extremely important in keeping the world running, so much so that it's on the EU's list of critical raw materials. But there's a giant problem. The world is running out of natural rubber. Several factors have put the world's rubber supplies into jeopardy. Commercially produced natural rubber usually comes from the Hevea brasiliensis rubber tree. Producers tap the trees and collect the sap produced. This sap is called latex, and to collect latex is an extremely labor-intensive process as each tree must be manually tapped. Collectors of the latex then process the latex at a basic level, dry it out, and then ship it. More processing happens further down the supply chain depending on what the rubber will be used for. Rubber trees must grow for about 7 years before they are ready to be tapped. In 2020, Southeast Asia produced roughly 70% of the world's rubber production. Millions of small plantation owners produced the majority of the global supply of natural rubber. Rubber producers have little supply of power due to the fragmented nature of production in the industry, among other reasons. The pandemic has had a profound effect on rubber supply, although the industry was struggling before the pandemic as well. The pandemic highlighted the lack of stability in natural rubber production. The demand for rubber is increasing for a number of reasons, such as populations increasing and economies growing. Then there's the fact that rubber is an important substance in healthcare during the pandemic. You would think that the increasing demand for natural rubber should be beneficial for rubber producers, but that's not the case. The price for rubber isn't set by the producers, but rather the Shanghai Futures Exchange in China sets the price for rubber. The global supply of natural rubber, roughly around 20 million tons per year, is produced almost entirely by fragmented owners who work tiny plots of land in tropical forests. The price of natural rubber doesn't reflect the work needed for processing, and this is leading to producers moving into other, more lucrative industries. Producers can sell off the rubber trees for timber. They can also make the same amount of money for less work growing oil palm trees. Because of the way the market works, the price of rubber per ton can easily be 300% higher or 300% cheaper in price from 1 month to the next. In recent years, rubber prices have been held at very low values. Rubber prices are cyclical, as they go up and down in response to different factors in the market. When prices are high, there's incentive to plant rubber trees. When prices are low, there's little incentive to plant and invest in a farm. And the trouble is that it takes anywhere from 4 to 7 years for a rubber tree to mature before it can be tapped for latex. Planting thousands of trees on a family farm years in advance requires much advanced planning, which ultimately is a big gamble. The recent low prices forced many farmers to overtap their trees to obtain more rubber, but that weakens the plants and makes them more susceptible to disease. Then, in a double whammy, the low prices have also discouraged farmers from planting new trees. Many farmers have simply abandoned plantations entirely. In addition to rubber price volatility, producers are affected by several other factors as well, such as labor shortages, diseased plants, and disturbances further up the supply chain. While natural rubber comes from rubber trees, rubber can also be produced synthetically from petroleum byproducts. But there are differences. Natural rubber has a high tensile strength, meaning it doesn't break easily under tension. It's less likely to tear than synthetic rubber. Natural rubber is used in tires because it adheres well to steel cords used to shape the tire. In fact, rubber is excellent at adhering to many materials as well as to itself, making it a very versatile substance. However, the quality of natural rubber can be compromised by light, heat, and ozone in the air, and quality can reduce over time. Synthetic rubber is constantly being improved and can be designed specifically to improve on some of the limitations of natural rubber. It's more resistant to heat and abrasion than natural rubber. Synthetic rubber can be produced to be flame resistant and can stay soft and flexible at lower temperatures too. Winter tires for cars are usually made of synthetic rubber. The rubber in winter tires is softer and therefore can grip the road better at temperatures below 45 degrees Fahrenheit. Natural rubber is rigid at this temperature, causing driving to be much more dangerous. Synthetic rubber is also less likely to cause allergic reactions on contact with human skin. Synthetic rubber offers a temporary solution, but the production depends on fossil fuels. Rising oil prices means that the production of synthetic rubber isn't always economically viable. The pandemic has had a serious impact on rubber production. Because of the fluctuating rubber prices, the industry has always relied on just-in-time manufacturing to reduce costs. This makes it difficult for suppliers to be flexible and adapt to volatility caused by restrictions and fluctuating demand. Rubber demand initially dropped at the beginning of the pandemic, as people stayed home during lockdowns. Less movement of people meant less use of cars and other methods of transport. Then, demand for rubber shot up as the demand for cars shot up. Natural rubber is essential for certain products that have been key during the pandemic as well, such as gloves and packing tapes, further increasing the demand. Increased demand for natural rubber further amplified the rubber problem with issues in rubber supply. Lockdowns caused factories to shut down, further dwindling rubber supply. Processing of the raw materials required for rubber was restricted, as well as the refining and manufacturing steps that create finished rubber products. On top of that, many producers depend on migrant workers to process the latex. But those migrant workers couldn't travel because of border restrictions. Many rubber trees went untapped as producers struggled with labor shortages. Then, China took the precautionary measure to stockpile rubber. This further aggravated the supply-demand imbalance as availability for everyone else was limited. Several environmental factors have also been recently hindering the production of rubber. Flooding in rubber-producing regions has been getting worse, preventing producers from tapping trees. In 2020, in Thailand, heavy flooding prevented rubber producers from tapping trees. In the long run, climate change will mean some areas where rubber is currently produced will no longer be suitable for its production. Currently, rubber-producing areas have already experienced the effects of climate change. The Rubber Authority of Thailand estimated rubber production in affected areas dropped by 100,000 tons that year. Disease has also already had a devastating effect on natural rubber production. Rubber trees are no longer commercially produced in South America because of South American leaf blight. This pesticide-resistant disease originated in the Amazon basin, but quickly spread to other Brazilian states. White root disease is another disease that's posing a risk to the industry. It attacks the root system of rubber trees. By the time the disease is visible above ground, it's too late to save the tree. Because the fungus that causes white root disease can survive and spread for several yards through the soil in the absence of wood, this means it's highly infectious. Increasing rubber production means more land needs to be cleared in order to grow rubber trees. In fact, rubber plantations have long been a main cause of deforestation, which reduces biodiversity in plants, animals, soil, fauna, and microbes. Less than half of the species that exist in natural forests can exist in rubber plantations. As well as reducing biodiversity, rubber plantations have a lower overall ecosystem function. There are other ways of producing natural rubber from different types of plants that are currently being researched. One of these plants is the Kazakh dandelion, a plant that's native to Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, and Uzbekistan. The Kazakh dandelion produces 8 to 10 times less rubber than a rubber tree does per acre. However, it grows fast and is ready to harvest within 3 months. And it reproduces rapidly, providing a lot of seeds. A byproduct of the Kazakh dandelion called inulin could also be turned into bioethanol through fermentation, and the remaining parts of the plant could be used to produce biogas. Fraunhofer ISC, a German research institute, unveiled a new tire named Biscaya, made from dandelion rubber. Supposedly, the tire made from dandelion rubber is more resistant to wear and tear than commonly used rubber. Another promising rubber-producing plant is Wayuli. This plant grows naturally in the desert between the US and Mexico. This is particularly favorable because it means that rubber can be produced in regions that are tough to grow anything commercially viable in general. In 2015, tire manufacturer Bridgestone released the first tire made from Wayuli-derived natural rubber. Will new rubber alternatives change the industry? Only time will tell. Click to watch one of these next videos. Let us know in the comment section what price change as a result of the pandemic has affected you the most.